Welcome to edupediaworld.com. This is Somjaja Nair, your online biology tutor. Biotechnology, as you would have learned from the previous chapter, it essentially deals with industrial scale production of biopharmaceuticals and biologicals using genetically modified microbes, fungi, plants and animals. In this video, we are going to discuss about the applications of biotechnology. The applications of biotechnology include therapeutics, diagnostics, genetically modified crops for agriculture, processed food, bioremediation, waste treatment, and energy production. Three critical research areas of biotechnology. The first one, providing the best catalyst in the form of improved organisms, usually a microbe or pure enzyme. Second one, creating optimal conditions through engineering for a catalyst to act. Third one, downstream processing technologies to purify the protein or organic compound. Biotechnological applications in agriculture. Let us take a look at the three options that can be thought for increasing the food production. The first one, agrochemical based agriculture. Second one, organic agriculture. Third one, genetically engineered crop based agriculture. What is Green Revolution? The Green Revolution was a period when the productivity of global agriculture increased drastically as a result of new advances. During this time period, new chemical fertilizers and synthetic herbicides and pesticides were created. The chemical fertilizers made it possible to supply crops with extra nutrients and therefore increase yield. The newly developed synthetic herbicides and pesticides controlled weeds, deterred or killed insects and prevented diseases, which also resulted in high productivity. In addition to the chemical advances utilized during this time period, high yield crops were also developed and introduced. High yield crops are the crops that are specifically designed to produce more overall yield. A method known as multiple cropping was also implemented during the Green Revolution and led to higher productivity. Multiple cropping is when a field is used to grow two or more crops throughout the year so that the field constantly has something growing on it. These new farming techniques and advances in agriculture technology were utilized by farmers all over the world and when combined intensified the result of the Green Revolution. Effects of Green Revolution. The Green Revolution succeeded in tripling the food supply, but yet it was not enough to feed the growing human population. Increased yields have partly been due to the use of improved crop varieties, but mainly due to the use of better management practices and use of agrochemicals like fertilizers and pesticides. However, for farmers in the developing world, agrochemicals are often too expensive and further increases in yield with existing varieties and not possible using conventional breeding. If there is any alternative method that our understanding of genetics can show so that farmers may obtain maximum yield from their fields? Is there a way to minimize the use of fertilizers and chemicals so that their harmful effect on the environment are reduced? The use of genetically modified crop is a possible solution for all these things. Genetically modified organisms or GMO. Plants, bacteria, fungi and animals whose genes have been altered by manipulation are called genetically modified organisms or GMO. GM plants have been useful in many ways. Genetic modification has, first one, made crops more tolerant to abiotic stress like cold, drought, salt, heat. Second one, it reduced the reliance on chemical pesticides because of the pest-resistant crops. Third one, it helped to reduce post-harvest losses. Fourth one, it increased the efficiency of mineral usage by plants. This prevents early exhaustion of fertility of soil. Fifth one, it enhanced the nutritional value of food. Example, vitamin A enriched rice. Pest-resistant plants. Some of the applications of biotechnology in agriculture that you will study in detail are the production of pest-resistant plants, which could decrease the amount of pesticides used. Bt toxin is produced by a bacterium called Bacillus thuringiensis. BT toxin gene has been cloned from the bacteria and been expressed in plants to provide resistance to insects without the need of insecticides. In effect, created a biopesticide. Examples are BT cotton, BT corn, rice, tomato, potato, soybean, etc. Here you can see the pictures of pest resistant plants. BT toxin. Some strains of Bacillus thuringiensis produce proteins that kill certain insects such as leptospirants like tobacco budworm, armyworm, coleopterans like beetles, dipterans like flies, mosquitoes. Bacillus thuringiensis forms protein crystals during a particular phase of their growth. These crystals contain a toxic insecticidal protein. Why does this toxin not kill the bacillus? Actually, the BT toxin protein exists as inactive protoxins. But once an insect ingests the inactive toxin, it is converted into an active form of toxin due to the alkaline pH of the gut, which solubilizes the crystals. The activated toxin binds to the surface of the midgut epithelial cells and create pores that cause cell swelling and lysis and eventually cause death of the insect. Specific BT toxin genes are isolated from Bacillus thuringiensis and incorporated into several crop plants such as cotton. The choice of the genes depend upon the crop and the targeted pest, as most BT toxins are insect group specific. The toxin is coded by a gene named CRI. There are a number of them. For example, the protein encoded by the genes CRI1AC and CRI2AB control the cotton bollworm. That of the CRI1AB controls corn borer. RNA interference. A novel strategy was adopted to prevent the infestations in plants by nematodes, which was based on the process of RNA interference or RNAi. RNAi takes place in all eukaryotic organisms as a method of cellular defense. This method involves silencing of a specific mRNA due to a complementary double-stranded RNA molecule that binds to and prevents translation of the mRNA, that is called silencing. The source of this complementary RNA could be from an infection by viruses having RNA genomes or mobile genetic elements called transposons that replicate via an RNA intermediate. A nematode called Melidiogen incognita infects the roots of tobacco plants and causes a great reduction in yield. RNAi method was used to avoid this infestation. Using agrobacterium vectors, nematode-specific genes are introduced into host plants. The introduction of DNA was such that it produced both sense and antisense RNA in the host cells. These two RNAs, being complementary to each other, formed a double-stranded dsRNA that initiated RNAi and thus silenced the specific mRNA of the nematode. The consequence was that the parasite could not survive in a transgenic host expressing specific interfering RNA. The transgenic plant therefore got itself protected from the parasite. This is a diagrammatic representation here of host plant generated double-stranded RNA triggers protection against the nematode infestation. The first one, that is A, root of a typical control plant. The B is a transgenic plant, roots 5 days after deliberate infection of nematode, but protected through the novel mechanism, that is the RNAi mechanism. Biotechnological applications in medicine. The recombinant DNA technology process that have made immense impact in the area of healthcare by enabling mass production of safe and more effective therapeutic drugs. Further, the recombinant therapeutics do not induce unwanted immunological responses, as is common in case of similar products isolated from non-human sources. At present, about 30 recombinant therapeutics have been approved for human use the world over. In India, 12 of these are presently being marketed. Insulin. Management of adult onset diabetes is possible by taking insulin at regular intervals of time. What would a diabetic patient do if enough human insulin was not available? If you discuss this, you would soon realize that one would have to isolate and use insulin from other animals. Then you have another question. Would the insulin isolated from other animals be just as effective as secreted by human body itself, or would it not elicit any immune response in the human body? Now imagine, if bacteria were available that could make human insulin. Suddenly the whole process has become so simple. You can easily grow a large quantity of bacteria and make as much of insulin as you need. Insulin used for diabetes was earlier extracted from the pancreas of slaughtered cattle and pigs. Insulin from an animal source, though, caused some patients to develop allergy or other types of reaction to the foreign protein. Insulin consists of two short polypeptide chains, chain A and chain B, that are linked together by disulfide bridges. In mammals, including humans, insulin is synthesized as a prohormone, like a proenzyme. The prohormone also needs to be processed before it becomes fully mature and functional hormone, which contain an extra stretch called C-peptide. The C-peptide is not present in the mature insulin and is removed during the maturation into insulin. This is the diagrammatic representation of the maturation of proinsulin into insulin after removal of the C-peptide. Genetically engineered insulin. The main challenge for the production of insulin using rDNA, that is the recombinant DNA technique, was getting insulin assembled into a mature form. In 1983, Eli Lilly, an American company, prepared two DNA sequences corresponding to A and B chains of human insulin and introduced them in plasmids of E. coli to produce insulin chain. Chain A and B were produced separately, extracted and combined by creating disulfide bonds to form human insulin. Gene therapy. Gene therapy is a collection of methods that allow correction of a gene defect that has been diagnosed in a child or embryo. Here, genes are inserted into a person's cells and tissues to treat a disease. Correction of genetic defect involves delivery of a normal gene into the individual or embryo to take over the function of and compensate for the non-functional gene. The first clinical gene therapy was given in 1990 to a 4-year-old girl with adenosine deaminase deficiency. Adenosine deaminase deficiency and gene therapy. Adenosine deaminase enzyme is crucial for immune system to function. The disorder is caused due to the deletion of the gene for adenosine deaminase. In some children, ADA deficiency can be cured by bone marrow transplantation. In others, it can be treated by enzyme replacement therapy, in which functional ADA is given into the patient by injection. But the problem with both of these approaches is that they are not completely curative. As a first step towards gene therapy, lymphocytes from the blood of the patient are grown in culture outside the body. A functional ADA cDNA using a retroviral vector is then introduced into these lymphocytes, which are subsequently returned to the patient. However, as these cells are not immortal, the patient requires periodic infusion of such genetically engineered lymphocytes. However, if the gene isolate from bone marrow cells producing ADA is introduced into cells at early embryonic stages, it could be a permanent cure. Molecular diagnosis. You know that for effective treatment of disease, early diagnosis and understanding its pathophysiology is very important. Using conventional method of diagnosis like serum and urine analysis, etc., early detection is not possible. Recombinant DNA technology, polymerase chain reaction and enzyme-linked immunosorbent assay are some of the techniques that serve purpose of early diagnosis. Polymerase chain reaction. Presence of a pathogen, bacteria or virus, etc. is normally suspected only when the pathogen has produced a disease symptom. By this time, the concentration of pathogen is already very high in the body. However, Very low concentration of bacteria or virus at a time when the symptoms of the disease are not yet visible can be detected by amplification for the nucleic acid by PCR. PCR is now routinely used to detect HIV in suspected AIDS patients also. It is being used to detect mutations in genes in suspected cancer patients too. It is a powerful technique to identify many other genetic disorders. Recombinant DNA technology. A single-stranded DNA or RNA tagged with a radioactive molecule or probe is allowed to hybridize to its complementary DNA in a clone of cells followed by detection using autoradiography. The clone having the mutated gene will hence not appear on the photographic film because the probe will not have any complementarity with the mutated gene. Enzyme-linked immunosorbent assay. ELISA is based on the principle of antigen-antibody interaction. Infection by pathogen can be detected by the presence of antigens, that is proteins, glycoproteins, etc., or by detecting the antibodies synthesized against the pathogen. Transgenic animals. Animals that have their DNA manipulated to possess and express an extra or foreign gene are known as transgenic animals. Transgenic rats, rabbits, pigs, sheep, cows and fish have been produced, although over 95% of all existing transgenic animals are mice. Here you can see pictures of some transgenic animals. Benefits of transgenic animal. First one, normal physiology and development. Transgenic animals can be specifically designed to allow the study of how genes are regulated and how they affect the normal functions of the body and its development. Example, study of complex factors involved in growth such as insulin-like growth factor. Second one, study of disease. Many transgenic animals are designed to increase our understanding of how genes contribute to the development of disease. These are specially made to serve as models of human diseases so that investigation of new treatment for disease is made possible. Third one, biological products. Medicines required to treat certain human diseases can contain biological products, but such products are often expensive to make. Vaccine safety. Transgenic mice are being developed for use in testing the safety of vaccines before they are used on humans. Fifth one, chemical safety testing. This is known as toxicity or safety testing. The procedure is the same as that used for testing toxicity of drugs. Transgenic animals are made that carry genes which make them more sensitive to toxic substance than non-transgenic animals. They are then exposed to toxic substances and the effects are studied. Ethical issues. The manipulation of living organisms by the human race cannot go on any further without regulation. Some ethical standards are required to evaluate the morality of all human activities that might help or harm living organisms. Going beyond the morality of such issue, the biological significance of such thing is also important. Genetic modification of organism can have unpredictable result when such organisms are introduced into ecosystem. The Indian government has set up an organization such as GEAC, Genetic Engineering Approval Committee, which will make decisions regarding the validity of GM research and safety of introducing GM organism for public services. Biopiracy. Use of bioresources by multinational companies and other organizations without proper authorization from the countries and people concerned without compensatory payment is called biopiracy. Thank you. Thus, I am winding up this chapter. In the next video, we will be moving towards the next chapter, the organisms and population.